larger part of your career was the Aditya Birla Group. I mean, you were the CFO for a long time. You handled or set up their retail business. And it struck me the other day when, I mean, the possibility of speaking to you that I should also ask you, I mean, you would have been in the hot seat at Aditya Birla Group today if Kumar Mangalam Birla were to ask someone what to do with Vodafone Idea. You were the go-to man then. What would you have told him? Because he's walking away, it seems, from Vodafone Idea. He doesn't want to put in any more capital. What would your advice to him at this juncture would have been?
You know, then I wish I could have given him some advice, but again, the reality is that I have not been in the telecom sector for many, many years. I last worked in the Aditya Birla Group almost 13 years ago, and of course, at that time, the telecom sector was taking off, and I was a big votary when I was in the group that the group should stay in telecom. But of course, everything, the whole landscape, the whole environment has changed over the last so many years. So I don't know. I would not have been able to give him advice without having been, actually in the telecom sector, working with him for some time. Because it's not just a question of what's happening in the sector, it's also a question of what's happening in the rest of the group and, you know, how is the group positioned and what the thinking is about growth areas and so on. So you can't just, you know, give that advice in isolation. So I would hesitate to be able to give you any answer on that.
Okay, let me go back to my first question to you then. I mean, how is it in the family for you guys? You know, your father is now with the Trinamool Congress. He was a prominent political leader. Your brother had 12 years in McKinsey before he chose to get back into the political path. I mean, it's fascinating for us on the outside to think of what dinner table conversations would be like between the two sons and the father. What is it like?
Well, you know, Udayan, the good thing is we seldom have dinners together. And so therefore we very, you know, rarely get together to have any kind of conversations. And I think it's just as well because all of us have such differing views on so many issues that it would not lead to a very constructive conversation. So I think, look, we're all professionals. We're all, you know, doing our own thing in our own different ways. And we keep our professional side very separate from the personal side. It may be hard to believe for a lot of people who are looking at it from the outside, but you know, frankly speaking, you know, between my father and myself, we, you know, he's run his professional career totally separately from me. I have not had any visibility into what he's been up to or what he's thinking of or what he's doing, and obviously no ability to influence. And the same thing with my brother. I think he does whatever he thinks is appropriate from his standpoint. So I think from that standpoint, we are all very, very separate individuals.
So finally, if I were to ask you, Sumant, I mean, since this is your big game in life, I mean, you've had a corporate career, but this is your baby. I mean, this is entrepreneurship. Where do you see yourself in 10 years' time? And if I had to ask you for a very brief mission statement or vision statement, what are you trying to create with ReNew Power? What is the scale of your ambition?
Well, then that's really, really a terrific question. And that's something obviously that I've thought about many, many times. And you're absolutely right. ReNew is my baby. It's grown much faster and much more than I had ever thought when I started the company. My aspirations have obviously grown over time with what we have been able to achieve at ReNew. New horizons have always continued to open up as our sector has grown and as our company has grown, and I'm sure that will continue to happen in the future as well. But since you've asked me the question right now, let me try to respond about, you know, where I am right now. So look, we are at this point close to a $5 billion market cap company, about $9 billion enterprise value. We have, as I said, up close to a 10% market share of the Indian renewables market, which itself is growing rapidly. What I'd like to do essentially is to help India in this energy transition. I think it's going to be a mammoth task. And as I said earlier, it's a once in a lifetime task. But I think it's a very, very critical thing for us to do because the choices that India makes on our energy systems are going to be very fundamental in the world's battle against climate change. Because India is already 8% of carbon emissions globally. And because we are growing so rapidly, given our pace of development, that percentage is going to keep going up. And we can't let that happen. And at the same time, we can't also prevent growth from happening. We have to, given the standards of life and the economic per capita incomes and so on, We have to make sure that Indians have the unfettered right to grow. And therefore, converting our energy systems from carbon-based to clean-based systems, I think, is a very important aspect. And I think if I can contribute to that in some measure, that would be a job well done.
I'm sure you'll go on to do that, Sumant. The journey has just begun, and it's begun very well for you. So I wish you all the best, and may you go on to achieve all that you have in mind, your vision and mission plan. Thank you very much for taking time out for us today.